Congress MLA stage walkout from the assembly proceedings as no discussion on complete loan waiver takes place. And four persons of a family killed in Santa Cruz Chol cylinder blast leaves three injured. Thank you, Rukma. Hi, and welcome to Metro Scan from Mumbai. I am Shama Mishra. Let's see the news in detail now. On the fourth day of monsoon session, the opposition got split as only NCP MLAs participated in the proceedings of the assembly. Congress MLAs staged a walkout from the assembly today as there were no discussions about the loan waiver for farmers. Cooperatives Minister Chandrakant Patil said farmers will have to pay the remaining loan amount to the State Land Development Bank as the concession has already been given to the farmers, which cannot be given again. About the issue of dilapidated buildings, Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis announced a bill will be introduced in this session and the residents should get the houses which will be built at the same place and within a given period of time. Congress leader Manik Rao Thakre said only if the government gives a favourable reply to the demands of complete loan waiver, they are ready to talk to the government and will participate in the house proceedings. Now, four persons of a family were killed and three were critically injured in a cylinder blast in Santa Cruz slum. This incident occurred in Golibar Chol at around 11 a.m. in the morning. According to officials, one critical person who sustained nearly 90% burns in a mishap was admitted to Kasturba Hospital, while two others are under treatment in VN Desai Hospital. Eyewitnesses say that the fire spread in a matter of minutes and burned down the entire house.
11:30 बजे कुछ इधर हादसा हुआ, गैस का बाटला लीक हो रहा था. लीक होते होते एक औरत वो लीक हुआ बाटला निकाल रही थी, तो उतने में उसके मुंह पे गैस आ गया. गैस आने के बाद पूरा आग लग गई लाइट की वजह से. दिया चल रहा था उधर ही आग लग गई, तो हम लोग वही आके बचाए.
ये जो हादसा हुआ है वो सिलेंडर गैस का कुछ लीकेज था पाइप में, वो लीकेज की वजह से आग लग गई. वो आग की वजह से वो फैमिली, दीक्षित फैमिली जो है हमारे वार्ड में गोलीबार नाके थर्ड रोड पे, तो उसमें से चार फैमिली मेंबर एक्सपायर्ड हो गए और एक जो सेल कुमारी करके उनको हम लोग ने कस्तूरबा हॉस्पिटल आगे उपचार के लिए भेजा.
सर कितने जख्मी है टोटल इसमें?
और अभी वीएन देसाई अस्पताल में दो जख्मी है, लेकिन वो सीरियस नहीं है, वो ठीक हो जाएंगे. टोटल चार एक्सपायर्ड हो गए, एक सीरियस है और दो वीएन देसाई अस्पताल में एडमिट है.
Meanwhile, a female TV journalist was hit by goons while she was covering the news. Police has detained one accused and investigating the matter. State Education Minister Vinod Tawre expressed deep concern over the incident and assured that strict action will be taken against the perpetrators. Now, Congress Party today held a protest in Nagpur district demanding complete loan waiver for the drought-affected farmers of the state. They were protesting under the guidance of former MP Mukul Vasnik and various others. Vasnik said due to constant drought in the region, there is a need to pass fresh loans to farmers, and also demanded that the new loans provided should be interest-free. Meanwhile, farmers protested in the Solapur district for remuneration to sugar mill factories according to the FRP. On the occasion of World Youth Skills Day, various programs were organized across the state. In Mumbai, Kohinoor Technical Institute organized Kaushal Shivir, in which Governor of Maharashtra, C. Vidyasagar Rao, was the chief guest. In another function, Minister of State Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Dr. Ranjit Patil, said that the state government will collaborate with various industries in order to encourage skill development in the state. He further added that Maharashtra government has launched Pramod Mahajan Skill Development Scheme in accordance with skill development concept. An orientation program was also held by the IFLS Institute established in skill development across the nation. Many places across the state, including Osmanabad, Pune, Jalgaon and Hingoli, were also participating in the Pradhan Mantri Kushal Vikas Yojana by organizing various events. BSE today celebrated the listing of its 100 small and medium enterprises, becoming the first SME platform to capture a lion's share in the Indian SME market. The BSE SME platform offers entrepreneurs and investors an environment which enables the listing of SMEs from the unorganized sector scattered throughout India into a regulated and organized sector. State Minister for Energy and New and Renewable Energy, Chandrasekhar Bavankule, who was present at the event, said that it's an achievement for the recently turned 140-year-old BSC to list SMEs under its umbrella. He also said that BSC is going to play a vital role in near future, as without it, Make in Maharashtra initiative cannot strengthen its roots. The Indian Merchants Chamber hosted an interactive meeting on MCGM's initiatives on education, healthcare and infrastructure with the Municipal Commissioner Ajoy Mehta. Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai, while interacting, Mehta stated that Mumbai has the cleanest water supply sources among any Indian metro. He also said that the Daman-Ganga-Pinjal Interstate River Link project to give Mumbai's water woes a permanent fix and would benefit the city tremendously. Later, he admitted that there were issues regarding the development plan, but everything would be sorted out with time and effort. The third consecutive year for an exclusive business event on small cells for 4G networks was organized recently in association with Cellular Operations Association of India and Think Small Cells. All industrialists highlighted that with the growing mobile data consumption in India and the focus on getting the larger population covered under the Digital India vision, it is important to take into consideration the latest technological and networking innovations like deployment of small cells into consideration, which will make the truly digital revolution a success. The summit also created a successful platform to discuss the future needs of telecom networks, which would be required to create a better use for experience. That's it then in this edition of Metro Scan from Mumbai. We'll be back tomorrow evening with more updates from the commercial capital. Till then, it's back to Delhi studios. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.